A question I always get asked is, well, do you ever get these guys hitting on you that you have no interest in other than being friends with? How do you handle that? Well, you simply be kind and you say, you know, I'm glad we're friends, or I'm glad that, you know, we have this bond of friendship. You know, I try to be gentle, and I have a lot of guys who are great guy friends, and that's as far as it's ever going to get. My heart has been broken too many times to try again. My heart is on reserve, if you will, if I ever have that happen. But I know in my heart, you know, I've had, well, 4 good chances at love, but out of 4, you know, I've messed things up so royally, and I blame myself a lot for things that happened. And I know that a relationship takes 2, so it's not all one-sided with my mess-ups. But my new thing is, I'm independent. I'm going to do this on my own. And the rest of my guy friends are just going to be great guy friends to give me advice, especially on child raising, and, you know, be there as a support team. But other than that, my heart's too broke. And I'm being honest. I don't like to be one of them that would lead anybody on or play a game, if you will. So, you know, the way I look at it is, if I can't have what I want, and yes, I'm stubborn, hard-headed, and prideful, then by God, I'll do it on my own. And I don't mean to hurt any feelings or anything. And I wanted to do a song tonight that reflected that. And, you know, if there's any man out there who wanted more than friendship with me, at this point, I'm not open to it, but I'm grateful for your friendship. And my heart is still broken. It is still not repaired. It probably never will be. So I'm just grateful for each learning experience I've had in my life. And that's how I'm moving forward with my life. And it's not perfect by any means, but life is never a box of chocolates. Oh, we have to laugh. So here is a song that one of my friends requested for me to sing, and I thought it was a perfect time for a little speech ahead of time. So here we go. It's a Lori Morgan classic. What part of no don't you understand? Sir, if you don't mind, I'd rather be alone. From the moment I walked in tonight, you've been coming on. If I told you once, I told you twice, I'm just here to unwind. I'm not interested in romance or what you have in mind. What part of no don't you understand? To put it plain and simple, I'm not into one-night stands. I'd be glad to explain it if it's too hard to comprehend. What part of no don't you understand? I appreciate the drink, and the rose was nice of you. I don't mean to be so mean, I don't think I'm getting through. Oh, I don't need no company, and I don't wanna dance. So what part of no don't you understand? What part of no don't you understand? To put it plain and simple, I'm not into one-night stands. I'd be glad to explain it if it's too hard to comprehend. What part of no don't you understand? I'd be glad to explain it if it's too hard to comprehend. What part of no don't you understand? What part of no don't you understand? Now everybody's saying, well, what if love finds you or surprises you? I said, there's only one way love is going to find me or surprise me, and it almost have to hit me over head with a cast iron skillet, because my heart belongs to one man, and it's complicated. That's all you can say to it. But there shouldn't be any complications in love, you know, but there are. And the way I look at it is, right now, my life is full to the brim with rim. I think that's an old commercial. I have got so many things going on in my life that I'm just trying to manage my life. And if love finds me, then great. If it doesn't, I can adopt a child on my own and be fine, you know. And the way I'm beginning to look at life is, you know, I had the virtual marriage. If that's the only marriage I ever get to have, then so be it. I never got the chance to walk down the aisle in the wedding dress that I own that I'm trying to sell. I never got the chance for the first wedding dance on a real floor, or for the guy to meet my parents. He met my mom and stepdad and my grandparents over the phone, but I never had that in face, in my space, real relationship. And I mean, with Mike, it was virtual for 8.5 years, you know. And I can't say that it was the worst of times, because we had some really great times. The first 5 years were amazing. But after that, it was just like we were on this downhill slide. And it just went from bad to worse to gone, you know. And from there, you know, it's live, love, and learn. And I just know in my heart of hearts, I've tried love. I would love for things to work out, but obviously he doesn't feel the same at this time. And Hallmark movies and romance novels, it always works out picture perfect, or even sometimes TV shows, but rarely in real life. I mean, we never see the girl go to the dentist, and right before she goes to the dentist, he lays one on her. And, you know, he's like, and don't you forget who you're coming back to, you know? She always has to go to the dentist by herself, or they just don't air that moment. And then later on, oh, honey, I'm home. Well, what happened to the dentist, you know? Who knows? But I'm just going to pray for the best, hope for the best. I will be with you again tomorrow night for another 20 questions. Surprise, surprise. I'm hoping to do some more relationship questions. So that may be the next thing that we do tomorrow night besides the 20 questions. And we're going to keep doing these all the way up till the 23rd. And after then, I don't know what's going to happen. But I'm grateful and blessed to be with you right now. So thank you for watching these. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for liking. God bless.